Hallöchen, meine Lieben, und willkommen zurück zu Let's Play Ex Mortis. Let's Play Together. Denn wir nehmen immer noch zusammen auf.
Jawohl.
Und ich würde es noch sagen, wir waren hier mit Lesen stehen geblieben und dann würde ich sagen, lesen wir mal weiter. 28. Mai 1997. I could not put it off any longer. I called in sick to the office today and decided that I would retrace my steps into the wilderness to once again find the house which has been foremost on my mind of late. I didn't take much to find it again, as it almost like I was being guided back to the exact spot that I found myself some 4 days ago. Once I plucked up enough courage, I pushed upon the unlocked front door. Admittedly, I was very surprised at the ease of which the door opened, considering that the hinge had probably built up to good 10 years worth of rust. To my relative astonishment, the place was still furnished. Though very dirty and completely run down, I was and still am amazed at the state of the place, considering that it had been empty for so long. I decided that I would explore the house and not disturb anything within. My fear had not subsided, and as a matter of fact, it is still with me as I record the journal some hours later. My curiosity took me through the kitchen, bedroom and lounge room before a thumping noise from the roof on the second level started me so much that I ran straight out of the front door and back through the forest off to my automobile. As it was, I almost fell off a small ledge and into the thicket below. I felt like a complete fool being scared off by rats, which I assumed they were. Also hat's verstanden?
Ja.
Hat ein Geräusch oben gehört und ist dann rausgerannt. 29. Mai 1997. I had a nightmare last night. All I can remember is the blood and the frightened screams surrounding me and the house. The house was in my nightmare too. 30. März, 30, nee, nicht mehr, sondern Mai. Verdammt, Entschuldigung. 30. Mai 1997. I called in sick to work once again so that I could venture out to the wilderness and explore the abandoned house once more. Not surprisingly, I found the structure with relative ease as I did yesterday. However, I was startled when I noticed that the front door was closed. I am certain that when I left in such a hurry the other day, that the door had been left ajar. In any case, I eventually attributed the closed door to the wind, as I was clearly the only person who had been in the old house recently. I repeatedly scoured through the house for anything interesting, heading back through previously visited rooms. Once again, as I passed through the hallway outside the main bedroom on the second level, I heard heavy thumping coming from the roof. I was instantly very tempted to repeat yesterday's dash from the house, but I swallowed my fear and continued on with the exploration. In the limited time that I had before dusk, unfortunately, I did not uncover anything that would help explain the mysterious disappearance of the most recent teenagers. Das heißt den AIDS, keine Ahnung. 31. Mai 1999. Ups, das war gerade. Muss doch nicht ich gewesen. Ich dachte schon, ich hätte mein Skype auf nicht beschäftigt gestellt, aber. 31. Mai 1997. I sit here in the lounge room of the old house by candlelight, recording in this journal the events that have been transpired today. Also, I am scared to within an inch of my life. I am bound to this house and feel that I do not have the strength or resolve to run back to my car at such an advanced hour. Entschuldigung. As I have for the past week, I return to this house with the intent of uncovering anything that could help answer the question of its missing tenant. I failed to uncover anything that could help the cause, but what I did find seems far more precious and disturbing than I could have ever hoped for. As I was scouring the library for any misplaced photos or letters, I almost tripped myself over a leather-bound book sitting in the middle of the dusty floor. Ich glaube, das ist das, was wir schon gefunden haben. I was certainly miffed as to how I missed it in my movement through this house of the past few days. Picking up the book, I felt a slight empowerment rush through me. The distant sound of wind began to sound like whispers, and the room in which I was standing seemed to darken. I wondered what knowledge the scribe has passed down the ages for me. Enchanted by this aging literature, I retreated back into the lounge room, sat down in one of the most comfortable chairs, and continued to read through the contents of this book. Written in what seems to be a red ink of some sort, das ist wahrscheinlich Blut, oh, a lot of the content didn't initially make sense to me, as the majority of it is written in a language that is foreign to me. But in the back of the book, there was abridged translations written by a Mr. Xavier Rayam from 1890. The majority of what I could understand seemed rather jumbled and nonsensical. Rather disappointed, I closed the book and relieved myself of its burden. Things from this point became rather blurred and frighteningly surreal. The sound of the distant forest animals stopped, as if all life paused waiting for my next move. The wind outside stopped pounding against the shuttered windows, and the candle winked out for existence, leaving me in almost pitch-black conditions. I listened closely, and all I could hear over my heartbeat and rasping breath was the whispering that I shrugged off before. It was coming from every direction, yet no directions at all. The whispering slowly got louder until it sounded like a dull roar. Voices of many different types called out. They cried in pain, screamed my name, and some shouted obscenities I dare not repeat. There were so many of them, so many voices. I felt multiple hands pin me down to the chair by my upper torso, but every time I flailed my arms out in front of me, they connected with nothing but air. The harder I was pressed against the chair, the harder it was for me to breathe, and soon I could not breathe at all. I blacked out. The last thing that I remember was a flash of my nightmare from the night before. A flash of the blood, a flash of the screams, the house. I woke up about 20 minutes ago, slumped in the same chair. It is now long after dark, and I dare not brave the sub-zero temperatures of the woodland winter to return home this evening. Tonight I will be staying here, in this accursed house. I sometimes think that I can still hear the whispering, or are they just echoes of my area brush with madness? I can feel the urge of slumber rush towards me like a freight train. I pray that I survive the night. 1. Juni 1997. Black by nightmares, more vivid than I care to remember, I awoke screaming. It appears that I slept through the daylight hours, but it didn't matter to me. I was incensed to fight the freezing conditions outside and return home, but I was scared to move from the spot. They started whispering to me again. I want to leave, but I can't. They won't let me. I scream at them, but they just laugh and utter obscenities back at me. What have I released upon this world? 3. Juni 1997. Flive spoke to me today. Keine Ahnung, was das für ein Name ist. It is he who is spoken of. It is he who is spoken of in the Ex Mortis. With every word he whispered into my mind, I tremble as if my soul has been shaken to its core. 7. Juni 1997. I have been here for over a week now. Surely someone must be looking for me by now. I pray that they find me. My captors here won't let me leave. Every door, every exit. The handles turn, but the door doesn't move on its hinges. Also er ist in dem Haus eingesperrt gerade. Anscheinend durch die Geister oder was das ist, so Dämonen oder so. Also, ja. Warte mal. Ich merke gerade was. So, das sind wir wieder. Warum waren gerade eben die Dinge verschwunden, die grünen Dreiecke, wo ich sehe, dass er auch wirklich aufnimmt. Ja, ich befinde mich im Vollbildmodus, ich weiß. Also, 16. Juni 1997. I no longer fear death. I actually pray that it comes to me, for me. Okay? Also, der Typ, der scheint wirklich ziemlich durchzudrehen gerade.
Scheint so.
30. Juni 1997. They still torment me, keeping me here, keeping me alive. They need me to, I can't even write of it. Sonst ist der Juli 1997. Oh, I feel my sanity has almost left me. I hallucinate so vividly. I can't tell what's real and what is not anymore. The ancients show me images of his former glory. I don't understand why they want me, why they need me. 26. Juli 1997. I am actually surprised. I am told that they seek not to control me. They only seek my assistance in aiding the inevitable. But why do I continue to resist? What they tell me makes more sense than anything I have What they tell me makes more sense than anything I have ever known. But I still fear them and what they will do to me should I refuse. But at this moment I can't think of a single reason why I should. 13. August 1997. Is acceptance all that I have nochmal. Is acceptance all that I have ever yearned for? But the greater good here is far more complicated, yet so much easier to obtain. The smile upon me now, strangely, for I like it. I find myself basking in the warm in the warmth of their chilling promises. 22. August 1997. I am comfortable. And I am learning about the true nature of the world and what is beyond it. I don't know why I continue writing in this journal. I guess that it's the last semblance of humanity that I have within me. It's ridiculous, for I am becoming much more than human with every moment that I spend under their patient tutelage. I have been tempted to throw this journal into the fire on many occasions. Reading over its pages only reminds me of how weak I used to be. I have lost track of the day, but I am sure that I have been here for over a year. It has been a long time since I have entered anything into this journal. I can rejoice, for we will have company at last. I will finally be rewarded. A group approached to provide me with the everlasting cup of life. A day away. No more. No less, I am told. Wrath. Death. Blood. My day has finally arrived. The ex mortis shall make the world remember what was. And I will be integral in reinstating what will be. I can see them now. A group of campers, as I was promised. 3 males and 2 females. Now all that I can do is wait. Wait for my time. Become their hand. Immortality beyond patents. Patents beyond dominion. I can taste it now. Anoint me, Lord, what wealth. The time has come. So anscheinend ist er irgendwie sowas wie ein Sklave von den Ex-Mortis geworden, und Ex-Mortis sind wohl diese Geister oder was auch immer das ist. Oh Mann. Also, storymäßig ist es anscheinend doch ganz schön gut ausgearbeitet. blood on the floorboards. It looks like someone's being dragged through here. Ja, das war einer der Camper gewesen. Ob wir auch einer von den Campern sind? Keine Ahnung. Jetzt habe ich wohl keine Ahnung, wo ich jetzt hier hin soll, ehrlich gesagt.
In einem Buch stand auch ein Datum drin, Jahreszahl. Vielleicht ist das der Code für das Schloss.
In dem
ein Buch.
In dem jetzt hier oder?
Nee, in dem davorigen.
Da war kein Kindergeheule. The door is now ajar. Die Tür ist jetzt offen. Oh. Gwen Wehame or just another hallucination? Siehste.
Ja, ich sehe sie.
The blood of Gwen Wehame stains the sheets. It was over 100 years ago that she was murdered, but how can the blood still be wet? Stop! Was war das? Okay. Das gefällt mir nicht. Uah. Wenn man wenigstens speichern könnte, verdammt. Naja. Nee, hier ist das. War noch mal die Library, also die Bibliothek.
Ich habe die Orientierung verloren.
Denkst du, ich nicht? Also hier schon mal das. So.
Da hattest du einen Schlüssel her.
Ja. Mal runter. Ach, wenn das nicht so lange dauern würde, als. War das hier? Nee, das wäre das. Nee, das ist ja nur der verschlossene Raum. Ach, doch, das ist ja richtig, ja. So.
1878, das würde ich mal oben in Dings eingeben.
In was?
Im Safe. 1878.
Warte mal, ich muss mal kurz eben.
Ich kann dir das auch gleich sagen.
Warte, ich hab doch einen Editor hier. So. Ja, gucken. Hier irgendwelche Zahlen noch.
Nein, vorne die erste Zahl würde ich nehmen. Das sind vier Ziffern. Bei den meisten Safe musst du auch nur einen vierstelligen Code
angeben. Ich frage mich nur, wo war der Safe nochmal?
Oben im Zimmer, ganz zurück, Treppe hoch.
Der war doch nicht oben, oder?
Doch.
Da war gerade ein Tappen. So. Ah, hier genau, stimmt.
So. 1878.
1878. Da geht nicht mehr irgendwas ein. Verstehe es nicht. 1878. Nö.
Gehen wir unten ins schwarze Feld rein. Ja, ins schwarze Feld.
Ne, müsste ja funktionieren.
Gar nichts.
Ich mach mal kurz einen Schnitt, weil ich schneide das ja sowieso gleich zusammen. Einmal 20 Minuten zusammen. Also bis gleich, Leute.